Hi, this is Clay King from AAA Flood Drying, and I wanted to show another way to cut out wet carpet. This has more to do with how you roll it up and handle it to dispose of it than it does to just cut it up. It's a little bit of both. I showed before how to cut a piece of carpet into pieces that would fit into a pickup truck. Sometimes, or in a decent number of situations, you want to cut up the carpet and get it into a trash bag like this, and you'd kind of like to get as much in the bag as you can, but you don't really want to make it so heavy that you can't pick it up. So today this is a different method of cutting it up. As always, one of the things that you want to do is you want to make sure that the blade and the knife is sharp and new, and as soon as it gets a little bit dull, just flip it over or replace it, because you don't want the cutting to be more difficult than it needs to be. So we've already done a couple of strips here, and what we're doing today is we're cutting the strips in about 16-inch wide strips, and then we're folding them over and rolling them up and putting them in a trash bag. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to pull this up. This has kind of been pulled up already, but I'm going to pull it off the tack strip, and I'm going to fold it over, and I'm going to come over about 16 inches and just make a cut. And that allows me to have a starting point for my knife. Then I'm going to lift the carpet up like this a little bit, put my knife in, and I'm going to be cutting with kind of the shank of the knife or the upper portion of the knife, not the tip. And you're picking it up so that you're not running the tip into the concrete, because it'll get dull really quick. You're not going to get a lot done. So we're going to put it in right up to here, and I'm going to lift up on the carpet, and I'm going to try and keep the carpet and the knife together. And it cuts fairly easy. And I do it on my hands and knees like this. It goes faster. I don't kneel down. And I cut, and it cuts nice and quick. Pick it up again, cut. And you are doing a lot of moving doing this, but I think it's worth it, because when you're done, it's easier to handle the carpet. I'm going to cut it off. Now I've got my piece free. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold this over, but I'm not going to bring it to the end like that, because when I roll it, it's going to tend to creep. So I'm actually going to overlap it, but I'm going to leave it like this with this lower piece extended, and then I'm going to roll it up. When you fold it like that, it takes half as much time to roll it up, because you've eliminated about half of the carpet. And then I start rolling. And as I roll, if you watch, this carpet's creeping forward. That's why I leave the lip, so that when I'm done, hopefully it stays a little bit better together if there's a single lip on the end. And then it makes a very nice tight package that you can handle easily, and you've got an awful lot of carpet in a small space. If it's really wet, you can let it dry by, or drain out by standing it up for a while, leaning it up against the wall, or take it outside of your house and let it lean like that for a while, and the water will run out. And then when you want to throw it away, pick it up, try and keep it together, open your trash bag, and put it in. And you can generally put, doing this, you can generally put two pieces into a bag of average lengths that you're going to cut before it gets too heavy to pick up. So you're going to get at least enough in a bag that you're making efficient use of the bags, and efficient use of your trips in and out of the house without carrying bags that are too light or too heavy. Try not to make them too heavy, you can hurt your back. Hope this helps you out with your flooded basements, and if you have any flooded basement needs in Massachusetts, we're located in Westford, Mass, and we serve all of Massachusetts and New Hampshire. And my phone number is 978-392-1895. Thank you very much for watching. Clay King, AAA Flood Drying.